You say you want to be a part of your child's life.
Of course you do. But have you asked yourself what that's going to mean?
I'm not going to just be a return address sending birthday cards and money. I want to be a father with everything that means.
Okay, but what does it mean? There are fathers, and there are fathers.
No, for me it means what's best for my son, and my daughter comes first.
And who gets to decide what's best? You? Catherine? Hey, you can just sit down. I'll be with you in a minute.
Actually, I was just looking for someone. There he is.
I don't understand what you're getting at. Catherine and I will both be deciding how our child should be raised.
And what if Catherine insists what's best for her is also what's best for the baby? It's kind of how she's been operating so far. She has you right where she wants you, doesn't she?
Juan, will you keep it down? The cops are used to him. Now, maybe they think things would get worse without him. I don't know, but it wasn't the local cops. It was the FBI. So that's what's the matter with Miss Skyle. And I heard her moving around a lot last night. But they can't keep Sonny, right? You know, he's got money, lawyers. Well,
right now, he's being held without bail.
Wow. Sounds like it must be bad.
Yeah, it is. Violation of the RICO statutes, that's what they said.
Is he guilty or what?
Nobody's gotten specific enough to say one way or the other.
One way or the other about what? Did you see him this morning? How is he?
Okay, waiting for his lawyer.
He shouldn't need a lawyer. He shouldn't be there at all. I mean, if the FBI went door to door asking people how they can make them feel safer, I hardly think locking up Sonny would make the top 10. Or even the top 10,000.
He's been through this before.
Harassed by the FBI?
Being picked up.
Well, you can't tell me he's okay with that. If you saw him, that means he can have visitors. And don't bother telling me that I can't see him. As soon as Tammy gets here, I'm out of here. Did you guys want something to eat, order, anything?
No.
Okay.
But cooked by you? Hey, easy. I didn't know Tammy left you in charge. Why are you acting like you're trying to pick a fight with everybody anyway?
Am I? Now you know how it feels.
Anything you want to ask? Since when would I get an answer? Since Sonny wanted me to check on you. I don't need to be checked on. Okay, I'm not Sonny's cat. I'm not his goldfish. I'm certainly not his son.
See, Juan, Sonny wanted you to know about his arrest before you saw it in the news. That's how he is. He treats people decently, whether they deserve it or not.
You know what? If he's in jail, he probably belongs there.
Jason? What, are you not speaking to me?
I didn't want to interrupt. You were concentrating.
Was I biting my lip? Lucky to say I do that when I sketch.
Maybe it helps.
I don't think so. You know, Emily's right. You're not like most people.
Yeah, I am.
No, I mean, anybody else would have asked what I was sketching. Or as a matter of fact, they would have asked to see what I was sketching or just stood right behind me.
Was it rude not to ask?
No,
I thought what you were doing was kind of private, and it would have felt like asking to read somebody else's letter.
Yeah, that's pretty much how I feel about it, too. But we're in the minority. So, how's everything?
Guess you heard about Sonny?
This is going to sound bad, because I know you're friends with him, and Emily is, too, but the main thing I felt when I heard about it was glad that it wasn't you.
They're looking at my tax records and stuff, but only to see if I'll get scared.
How can you tell?
They're my tax records. They already went to the IRS. What are they going to find out but whether I can add or subtract?
I cannot picture you in jail.
I'd look the same.
No, I mean... Okay, for instance, a deer in the woods does not look like a deer hanging over someone's fireplace.
Yeah, you know, Sonny doesn't look the same, actually.
So you went to see him?
Yes.
You know those rooms where they take you to visit? It's too bright in there. It's like the light is coming up from the floor. And it makes faces look all wrong, like they're going to float to the ceiling or something. And it makes the person sitting across from you look like someone you've never even seen before.
I can't stand seeing him there. I keep wanting to try to get him out. Sometimes doing nothing is the hardest.
Yeah.
Oh, it looked like you and Nicholas were having something out when I saw you.
How'd you know that was just what I was thinking about? Nicholas takes his responsibility seriously. I just can't help thinking about the way I felt growing up. My father got offered this fellowship in Russia. And I guess for him it was kind of a chance of a lifetime. And then my mom got pregnant with me. So they had to turn it down.
Does your father regret it?
Oh, no, never. I'm sure that's what he'd say. But from the day I heard my mom telling someone about it, I always wondered if that's why I never felt like I fit in with my family. You know, it's like my parents got this incredible opportunity and they had to turn it down because of me. I was never quite worth it. Dad, listen to me. How obnoxious can I get? This is not about me or my weird childhood. The only curse that child's going to have is Catherine Bell for a mother. You know, I may not know when to shut up, but thank goodness I did not tell Nicholas any of this.
That's too bad you didn't. I think you're right. Kids know what's going on. Even when they're real little, maybe especially then.
Why especially?
You can't talk a baby out of what he thinks or what he feels when they can't even talk yet, right? And what are you going to say? No, you're not really hungry? No, you're not really scared? The kid knows what he is.
True.
So they just soak up what goes on around him before anybody can explain it away. You did. You just said you did. Michael did. He knew what was going on between me and AJ even when only one of us was in the room.
Is that why you're not...
Yeah, that's why I don't see him anymore.
You should be proud.
I'm not.
Hey, not many people can make a decision like that.
I don't know. I'm only me.
You know, I may not be able to say this to Nicholas, but... If he despises Catherine and she keeps manipulating him, there's no way that baby's not going to know that they're miserable. Somebody's going to have to make some very unpleasant decisions. Anyway, it's not going to be me. I guess all I have to do is just be there for Nicholas when he needs me and be patient. Although, not that you ask, but being patient is one of those things that I'm basically terrible at.
Yeah, well, I'm not patient either. You know, when there's a situation you can do nothing about, you just got to do something else.
Like ride your motorcycle?
You've got the bug.
What bug?
You like to ride. You want to?
Can we?
Yeah. Let's go.
I know. I'm so late. I'm sorry. You've been waiting. I know. Jason, I'm sorry. You have no idea what it's like to try to slip out of a charity guild breakfast, you know? You make a path to the door. Somebody tackles you.
Is there a reason I need to know this? Carly, why am I here?
We have a problem.
We?
Okay, Sonny.
Oh, no. We're not back on hand now, are we?
Would it surprise you to know that Little Miss can do no wrong is packing heat?
Packing heat.
She has a gun. Hannah has a gun.
Not to be literal, but she threw me up against the desk.
Is this where you dreamed up this gun thing?
I didn't dream it up.
What, was there something hard on her pocket and you took that to mean that she's packing heat?
No, as a matter of fact, I saw it. Oh, I saw it.
You didn't mention it at the time?
Well, this doesn't have anything to do with what happened at the police station. I saw the gun before we went to the station. What do you think I was doing at the penthouse? Before the cops dragged me downtown, I was trying to tell Sonny that his girlfriend keeps a pistol in her underwear drawer.
Carly, keep it down. You broke into Hannah's room?
I have to break in. I own the building. My mother does. Okay. Fine.
That does not give you the right to break into somebody's
room. Wait a second. Okay, you're mad at me for trespassing, but not that Hannah has a gun?
What if Hannah would have walked in? You know the mess she'd be in?
As a matter of fact, she did walk in. Isn't that funny? She didn't mention it to the cops. She didn't mention it to you. Why do you think that is?
Because you're lucky this time, Carly.
Obviously, the woman has something to hide.
This is the part where you start giving me a headache again.
What is it going to take? What's going to make you admit something is way off here? Why does a waitress keep a gun? Unless she's got another agenda. And why, if she's so into Sonny, is she all cozy with her ex-boyfriend? Look, I saw the way she looked at him. The look did not say, go away.
Okay. I'm asking you. As a favor to me, give this Hannah thing up.
You know I'm only trying to help.
No, don't, Carly, don't help. Don't even think about helping. Carly, just leave it alone.
But you cared about Sonny.
I do. I also care about you. Come on, Carly, you don't need the grief. Leave Sonny and Hannah alone.
So what, just let her demolish him?
If that's where this thing is headed, how are you going to get in the way?
I'm going to tell him the truth.
Tell him what, that his girlfriend's trouble? He just want to hear that from you?
So then why don't you tell him?
Carly, you are carrying a message that Sonny will not accept. No matter how you try to send it, it will blow up in your face. You have Michael. You have AJ. You have this charity gig. Take care of your life, okay? Don't get in the middle of Sonny's business. He's not going to be grateful. He's going to be mad.
So he's mad. So what?
Because I hate defending you to Sonny.
You defend me to Sonny?
Don't put me in the position right now.
Not once have you said that I'm mistaken. You believe me, don't you? I can tell, Jace.
If Hannah's wrong, and I'm not convinced, but even if it is true, Sonny will get there on his own. He doesn't need to know that you got there first.
Fine. I tried.
You gonna drop this?
What are my options?
Can I trust you on this one? Carly, let it go.
I heard you, all right?
I hope so.